New theme.
Oh, this is new. This is like... Oh, nope, the animation changed. I was gonna say, it's like some Game Boy graphics. All the outfits you can cosplay in!
Ooh, yeah. If this show was made under different circumstances, it would be like all the merchandise you can buy.
Yeah, probably.
You can't, though.
I would like to reiterate again that Gamagori is my husband. Kinky.
The only reason that wasn't explicit is because they didn't draw the parts. Yeah. They didn't really cover them. They just didn't draw them.
Yeah, pretty much.
Why did she pronounce it like that?
What?
Did they always say it like that? Mikisugi instead of Mikisugi.
Probably just English voice acting. Odd emphasis.
I'm gonna go wherever she goes! I'm coming with and you can't stop me!
She's so precious.
Yeah.
Just talk with your mom in the bath. That's not awkward.
There's this song, too.
Yeah. I've actually been listening to this song a lot. I really like it.
I'm glad. I haven't listened to it as much recently, but I used to a lot.
Yeah. Just like the German. That,
Yeah, this is an uncomfortable scene here.
Yeah.
Are those scars on her back, or just...
Hmm.
Life fiber stuff? What's she wearing on her neck?
Probably some sort of necklace, which isn't really that smart, because it's gonna rust. Or tarnish, at least.
What's he wearing on his neck?
A cool thing. I don't know.
All the New to Speech guys have that. It's like a turtleneck, but like skin tight and just the neck part.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a screen. I thought it was like a chalkboard.
It's a digital chalkboard.
It has the pixels.
Humans didn't choose the clothes they wear. Instead, clothing chose us to wear it.
Okay.
Yes, this is the beginning of it all. The primordial life fiber.
It kind of looks like a golden gourd.
Yeah, a little bit.
Evolve decided to go dormant long ago.
Mikisuki's a good cosplayer.
Yep. I like all the drag he's in, too. That's gorgeous.
I slept for 6 months.
How do you know how long you slept for?
Good question.
Their clothes are found in almost every country.
Almost? I guess not Antarctica?
Yeah. Not like some really third world countries. Mako is the best.
Are they in a bathhouse?
It looks like it? So that's where that
I'm
came
missing.
From.
Yeah, I'm missing lots of bits of that.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
This is nudist beach, right? You got a problem with me being naked?
You're not naked.
Basically.
She still has underclothes on.
I mean, so do nudist beach.
True. I mean, to get it aired, they kind of have to.
They don't have to. They could be really clever with lots of convenient sensors.
True. That would have made it, like, way better.
That's a good screenshot.
Yeah.
I think I've seen someone who doesn't know Kill la Kill explain what's happening here.
I've seen that on Tumblr.
Also, new ending theme.
Hey. Oh, animation. It's cute.
I was gonna say it's actually less animated than the other one, but that's not true. Like, they're both ending themes are like just a slideshow, kind of.
Yeah, it's adorable.
It is.
I see a centaur, Mako.
Yeah.
First of all, oh my god, also a demon Mako?
Lots of Makos.
Are there dolls of this?
I wish. Those are like really good plushes.
Yeah. Someone should make dolls of those.
Okay, so I'm just going to interrupt for a moment here to say that up until this episode, I've always had Kill la Kill's first opening, Sirius, playing at a low volume underneath our conversation. And because this is the first episode to have the second opening ambiguous, I was going to have that playing underneath our voices here. And so I did that, but then when I uploaded this video to YouTube, it immediately got a strike and got taken down by Sony Music Entertainment Japan. So just to be safe, I think I'm going to stick with how I've been doing it so far with the first opening. And it's kind of disappointing because I kind of like the second one a little better, maybe. But, you know, just what I'm going to have to do. Also, I removed the music audio that was playing earlier during the reaction phase. Anyway, back to the video. And that was episode 16, The Girl Can't Help It. Which I...
Yeah, got some plot going on.
That title, I don't know how much that had to actually do with the events of the episode.
Eh, doesn't matter. It sounds cool.
Yeah. So, plot stuff.
Yeah, plot stuff.
We know all the secrets now, basically. Like,
yeah.
Remember...
Alien clothes.
Remember how Kill la Kill is like an alternate universe because of the World War II X-Powers winning the World War II thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, there's that, yeah. But, like... But there's also, you know, from much, like, very, very long before that, it's an alternate universe because, like... Life fibers is aliens, and they made the human race.
Yeah, that is like mind blown, dude. You know, surprisingly, I can accept this.
Surprisingly?
Yeah, I mean, okay. We all know that from the beginning, I was kind of skeptical of this show because, you know, oh, tits and ass.
Oh yeah.
But. The story is not that bad.
It's good.
Yeah, it is good. And it's just over the top enough that, you know me, I really like things that are over the top. Sometimes, like, I mean, I personally have read My Immortal at least 3 times.
Oh, wow.
This is My Immortal levels, but, like, things that are so over the top, it's, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think I do.
Yeah.
Heard about how My Immortal might have been, like, faked? What, like, made that way on purpose?
But yeah,
what's your opinion on that? Do you think it's true?
My opinion on that is I don't care because I still love it.
Yeah, I mean, it's a masterpiece either way.
Oh, yeah. If it is a troll fic, I think, that is some skill on the author's part, because damn. I mean, I can't even write troll fic that bad, or good, or whatever.
Oh, did you hear that? It was like a...
Oh. What was that?
It's not even a motorcycle, I thought it was, it's just a car that's going real fast outside my house. Wow. Anyway... The episode. So, one thing I noticed when Nui Harime was there for just a sec at the beginning when she was like flying the airplane thing.
Yes.
Like they subtly. Well, the thing I noticed about that is that when she was on screen, they made it like subtly unsettling, which I liked. I liked how they did that. Well, like the way that things moved. Well, in general, the things, I mean, they were saving some money on that scene in particular. Like, that stuff was just, you know, like a single image they moved around a bit.
Yeah.
When there was like a close up on Nui's face and the camera was kind of moving, so that there's that aspect to it which could, like, make you a little sick to your stomach. Because the camera's moving in that way.
Yeah.
But then also her eye just sort of slid to the right. Just like a perfect, like, tween from PowerPoint or something. And it just... The way that happened in combination with the way the other things in the screen were moving, it makes you feel a little bit sick, like, to look at.
Yeah.
Which they did on purpose, I'm sure. If they didn't, it was an amazing mistake.
I didn't even notice that.
I might be overanalyzing it a bit. But I know, like,
I
just...
she is your wife.
Yes. But I did notice that.
Yeah.
I'm not 100% sure if it was a thing by design, but I liked it.
Yeah. Sometimes mistakes are the best. Especially when they turn out good. And then you're like, that totally wasn't a mistake.
Oh, yeah.
I meant to do that.
I hear from my friends who write stuff sometimes that that happens a lot in writing.
Yep.
So, yeah, this episode was, I mean, it was mostly exposition.
Yeah.
The bulk of it. There was the recap part at the beginning.
And that awkward thing with Satsuki and her mom.
Yeah, that was hard to get through. And I also like the part when Satsuki said, like, there'll be a warm welcome waiting for you, mother. And then, like, it got all intense and, like, rock music started playing.
Yeah. That was the best. I don't think she likes her mom.
Not very much. She doesn't seem.
No.
And also just another little thing, like, when Sasuke was walking alongside Rakio, and Rakio's assistant, Homura, was behind her, or behind both of them, like, in the middle, and, like, there were colors on her sunglasses, which I think meant that, like, the light from Rakio's rainbow hair was reflecting off of them.
I thought that, too. That was a good touch.
Yeah.
That rainbow hair. A lot of people.
Hold on, I'm sorry, you afforded me this opportunity, and I'm gonna go for it. There were a lot of good touches in this episode, and one particularly bad touch.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Okay, now what were you saying besides that?
That was a good one. That was a good one.
What were you about to say?
A surprising amount of people in this have glowing body parts.
That's true.
First the nipples, then the hair, and, like, is there anything else?
I mean, probably.
Yeah. I think multiple people in Nudist Beach have glowing nipples.
Mako's personality?
Yup. I wonder if, like, that was a trait selected for by the life fibers. They were just like,
oh yeah,
you're gonna glow. You're gonna glow.
The reason Ragyo's hair is like that, like, I'm pretty sure is because of life fibers. Like, you know, the Kyrdewine family is the life fibers spokespeople, so it she's got them in there, I guess. But, like, but for Mikisugi, like, he's all against life fibers, so I don't know why. I don't think there's an explanation for him.
See, the whole fact that life fibers have been, in essence, breeding humans for their own gain kind of, like, gives you a ton of free rein for theories and shit. Like, you know, maybe all of the quote-unquote regular people, like the no-star people at Honnoji Academy, seem so stupid because, I mean, they're basically like domesticated animals which are kept in a childlike state forever. I mean, whole, like, glowing body parts and shit. I mean, the whole world is basically shaped by the life fibers, so that could explain a lot of the outlandish stuff, because clothes obviously wouldn't, like, follow the same logic as real life. So they shaped the whole world, and that explains why it's so over the top and
weird. Yeah. Still, I still am curious about what the rest of the world is like outside of Japan and
in
the colloquial world.
Probably similar. I mean, not like with the whole school children controlling their towns and stuff, but...
Yeah, well, I mean, that is specific to the Kiryu family.
Yeah.
Because, life fibers,
Yeah, but yeah, you would think...
They did mention in that episode that life fibers just awakened, like, 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Which did Reebok's, like, basically have a monopoly on all clothes in the world in just that time? That seems a bit short for that to happen. I don't know.
Not really. I mean, especially if you become a big brand, that can happen pretty quick. The main surprising thing is that they kept their monopoly on clothing. Because, you know, usually, especially fashion trends, they can come and go really quick.
Well, it might not be... Well, first of all, like, if they make all clothes, then, I mean, they can control fashion trends, too. But also, it might just be that 20 years ago they started, and now they're basically, like, around now they're reaching its peak, and that's why the events of the show are happening, because they're, like, they're gonna go full invasion or something.
Yep.
Soon.
I kind of want to see theories about, like, would life fibers influence fashion?
Well, not actively. Like, not they themselves, because, I mean, as Mikisugi said, they were, kind of dormant for a long time.
Yeah. But, like, if you think about some of the fashion choices in the past, I don't have thoughts to formulate on it, but I want to see other people's thoughts on it.
There's a blog that I followed, like, posts from the Kill Kill analysis and theories and stuff. I don't remember what it's called. I might link it in the description or something. I don't know. I doubt they have a post about that, but, like, I don't know. It's the kind of thing they might talk about there.
Yeah. Kind of thing I could drop and ask in their inbox about.
So one thing that I noticed in this episode that I remembered because I had read something about it before, but I didn't remember the specifics, so I just kind of looked it up quickly now. Near the beginning, when Ryuko and Mako and Mikisugi are looking over, like, the, like, destroyed remnants of that town they were in, they were near a lake, and you could, or, like, a body of water or something, and you could see in there, you could see floating there, there was, or sticking out of the water, there was the head of a statue of Colonel Sanders, the KFC mascot.
Really?
Yeah, and that was in fact a reference to, hold on, let me read this here. As a reference to when a particular Japanese baseball team was thought to be cursed because they threw a statue of the colonel into a river. So, I don't know, I guess they performed poorly after that or something,
cursed by fried chicken.
I mean, the illusion there being that bad stuff's about to go down.
Yeah.
A curse of some kind.
The question is it for, I mean, obviously you know, but is it for Nudist Beach, like, who have the statue in the water, or is it for the Kiyuans, who, in essence, caused the statue to get thrown into the water?
True. If it was thrown into the water in probably the same way as the story of the curse of the colonel, which I have the Wikipedia page open for it here, like, I don't know the details. But you might think that if it happened in the same way, then it was the followers of that crab guy, Zenny Teeth guy, who, you know, the money people, because for whatever reason. Or is it just because the whole town was destroyed in that fight and it just fell?
Yeah, that's what I thought. Because they were technically in the Nudist Beach headquarters, weren't they?
Yeah, or they were working with them in some way or another.
Yeah. I thought it was because, you know, Satsuki fucking blew up their entire base. That could cause some destruction, some things getting tossed into the water.
Yeah, probably.